Hello, I am Maximiliano Ferman. I'm a mobile web developer and author. I have created this course because sometimes it's difficult to scale and modularize your code when you're just creating web apps without libraries. In this course, we will cover some classic design patterns such as singleton, adapter, memento, as well as some design patterns that you can use in single and multi-page applications. You will be able to use these patterns to create more maintainable and scalable web apps using vanilla JavaScript. So we're going to apply two design patterns at the same time. We are going to create a mixing that will implement the observer pattern. Why? Because we will have a list, okay? So we have a list of to-dos. That list will change. I can add elements, I can remove elements. Make sense? So maybe I want to implement the idea of observer. I want observers to observe changes on the list. Make sense? So I can go and inject the observer pattern directly into my list, but I can create a mixin that I can reuse later on other classes as well. That's the idea of a mixin. I create behavior that then I can inject in one or more classes, okay? So in this case, we're going to create an observer mixin that is going to be an object, a literal object, that will have first a new collection. I can use a set. I mean, I can use an array if you want. The difference with the set is that there is no order, and also there is no, it doesn't accept duplicates. So I cannot add twice the same observer, the same function, the same callback. Okay, it's not going to accept the same callback again, which is a little better. So, and then I will have the addObserver method that will receive an observer. And we'll just, let's use method syntax. I can use arrow syntax as well, but anyway. Well, I will say this observer's add. So it will add the observer that we receive as an argument to our list. Then we have the removeObserver that receives an observer and is going to delete it from the list. By the way, this is a simple implementation of the observer pattern. It can be more complex. For example, when you subscribe, when you add an observer, you can also specify which event do you want to observe. In the case, the subject has different events, like load, change, delete. So you can clone the add event listener pattern. Okay, but in this case, we will create one observer that will be applied for just change. Okay, we are changing something. And then we notify. So there is a method notify that will take the list of observers. It will iterate over each observer and it will execute each observer. If you don't understand yet what's going on here, I'm missing a comma, the whole idea here is that if I have an object with the observer mixin, I can add an observer. And what's an observer? Anything, but I will pass functions. So I can create something like this. And then I can add another one and another one. So it's like an add event listener. And at some point, I can call observer notify. And notify will actually go through the three observers and execute them. Remember, this is a function. So actually the set observers will be a set of functions. So that's why I'm executing the function here. Now you will start seeing the advantages of using design patterns. Just for the sake of adding something, what if I want to type something and then use a shortcut, such as Control P, Control T, whatever, to hit the add. I mean, I can also use Enter, Return, but just to play with something different. Also, I can use the form element in HTML and use onSubmit instead of the onClick. That will be much better. But let's just stay with the idea of adding shortcuts, keyboard shortcuts. So how to add keyboard shortcuts here? Well, I could create another file, or I can do it here in app.js. I'm not sure if you have ever played with keyboard shortcuts, but I can just talk to the document and add an event listener for key down. So key down, we receive an event, and we should check, for example, if the control key is pressed, and if the key is, just pick any letter. P, T, T for to do, whatever. Control P is for print. No one is actually printing these days, so yeah, we can override that. So we can prevent default, so we don't get the print dialog from the browser. And then how to trigger the add operation? We just need to execute the command. The same command as we executed when we click the add the button. So just copy this, paste this here. We just execute the command, and that's all. So because we decoupled the execution, the action from the previous invoker of that action. So now if I execute and I type now dinner, I will not click the button. I will press Control P and you have it. So you can now easily implement keyboard shortcuts or gesture with your finger for the iPad. When you do a tick over the screen with your finger, you trigger the action, whatever you want. Now that it's decoupled, it's much simpler to all other invokers for the same command. Okay? Does it make sense? Now you can see that after we did the hard work, now everything is faster, that is smoother. Every new feature we add is actually pretty simple to implement. So when we load the project, actually all the pages are being loaded. So the web component of all the pages are being loaded. This is how modules work. When the page loads, the ECMAScript engine creates a tree, a modules tree. So I'm loading this module, that module is importing from another module, that other module is importing from another module. So it's downloading all the JavaScript files, okay? So that loading process is taking the network, is taking time in parsing and execution when the page loads. And maybe we can increase performance if we can do lazy load. So for example, if I'm in the home, I shouldn't download all the content for the order. If I'm getting into the order, I'm gonna do that. Okay, make sense? So now we are going to implement that. So to do that, the first step is to remove the static import. So right now, these static imports are in app.js. So if you open app.js, there is a section here that says web components imports. These are static imports. So this is the one that says, hey, you should download order page, even if you're not using it right now. So if I remove order page from here, then it's not part of the tree anymore, the import tree anymore. So if I go back here and refresh, I shouldn't be seeing order page, just menu page and details page, not order page. Now, if I go to order page, I see nothing rendered. Why is that? Because there is an order page component there, or tag, HTML tag, that has no web component register too. So it's empty. Okay, so what I need then is that when you go to that section, when you go to the order section, I want to dynamically import that file. So here we're going to implement a lazy load pattern. We will just do this. We're going to await for importing components order page, .js. Import is a new function. So it's the same import that we use at the top. It looks like the same, but this one is a function. The function version will dynamically load that and it returns a promise. Okay, so I can use then and catch, or I can use async await. But to use await, I need to change my function and convert that into an async function. Okay, if not, I can just stay with then. So I await for that, and it will just kind of stay there waiting for that import to appear. And now, I'm done. So, pretty simple. So, going back to the home, I'm refreshing. I'm going to order. And now I'm seeing something, which means it works.